Hi everyone, and welcome to the next foil review. Today I'm going to talk to you about the Alpine Foil Ultimate Carbon with the race wing. Alpine is a French brand and they've been making foils for a very long time. They've had sort of a mixed past. They've had some good products, some bad products. But for 2018, they seem to have addressed a lot of the issues specifically that I've had with their foils from the previous years. The newest foil out of their factory is the Ultimate. It is an aircraft aluminum carbon hybrid foil, and this came with the new race wing. Now just right from the bat, I would just like to say, this is not a race wing as per up and down racing. For example, the stuff we do in Formula Kite or the Hydrofoil Pro Tour. This is more of a long distance speed racing wing. And that's why it's actually quite a bit thinner and smaller than what you're used to. So even though it's called the race, this is more of a speed and crossing wing. One thing that's really cool about Alpine, they make really light foils. This setup weighs exactly 3 kilograms. The mast is 93 centimeters long from the bottom of the box head down to the fuselage. If you include the fuselage and the head, it's exactly 1 meter long. The mast has a tapered cord from 120 millimeters down to 110 millimeters, so from 12 centimeters down to 11 centimeters cord. It also has a varying profile depth. As I measured it, it's about 18 millimeters down to 16 millimeters. The race wing has a span of 61 centimeters and a cord of 9 centimeters. The back wing has a span of 42.5 centimeters by a cord, a center cord of 7.5 centimeters. The distance front to back, front wing to back wing, is quite large. It's 59 centimeters on this setup. The fuselage itself is 83 centimeters long. The stabilizer angle is variable. Alpine supplies you with a whole range of shims, which will allow you to get a stabilizer angle from 0 to 1.1 degrees. And the same thing for the front wing, they offer you shims to again change the angle of the front wing. I prefer to have 0 angle on the front wing and 0.7 degrees on the back wing when I was riding it. The mast features the KF box, the kite foil box, which is sort of a thicker power box style of box. So let's talk about some of the features. For 2018, Alpine have completely redesigned the fuselage. The Ultimate fuselage, again, is made out of aircraft aluminum. And the biggest feature on this is here. This is the sacrificial anode on here. In the beginning, I was actually quite skeptical if this would really work. So the way I tested it was, I didn't clean this fuselage with fresh water the entire 4 weeks I was testing it. So if you compare it to when it was new and shiny to now, if you have a look at it, that is actually quite corroded, whereas the rest of the fuselage did not ever build up any salt oxidation corrosion compared to the excess fuselage that I had, and definitely compared to my Moses Zico and Axis fuselages, they're also aluminum. Yeah, nothing built up on this, whereas on the other, all the other aluminum fuselages, so it would have built up immediately after one day. We have very strong salt water here. The Ultimate features an S-shaped mast. This is supposed to reduce or actually completely eliminate ventilation on the mast. And I did try quite hard to get it to ventilate. I had no ventilation problems whatsoever on this mast. It does have to say, even testing the same wing setup on the Axis fuselage and mast, which is completely straight, I also didn't have any ventilation problems on that either. So I'm not really 100% sure if it's down because to the mast or if it's just good design and profile design of the mast. The wing itself, the front wing, as you can see, is very different to a lot of front wings on the market. The biggest thing you'll notice right in the beginning are these really large but thin winglets. All right. Now, winglets are supposed to reduce drag and also prevent ventilation on the wing. And in theory, also increase the lift to drag ratio of the wing, increasing speed and lift. As with all the Alpine foils, the fuselage is very long, and your distance from your front wing to back wing is about 10 centimeters more than most foils on the market. This gives you a great pitch stability. The back wing I've tested is also the same back wing as on the Axis. It has a slight dihedral and just a little bit of a flip on the tips. The tips on these are, however, quite sharp and thin. One thing that is pretty amazing on all the Alpine stuff is the amount of engineering that goes into it. The fuselage is super clean and nice and amazing. The nose, however, for some reason on these, they look a bit strange. They look like they've been sort of rounded by hand. I'm not sure if you remember, the old Alpine fuselages had a very long and pointy nose, which was sort of a safety issue. And here, these are nicely rounded, and just, which is a bit weird, all the rest of it's finished extremely nicely, but here, the nose itself is, and you can see there's a few little sort of bumps and angles in there, as if that's done by hand. I'm not sure if that's because they've changed all the fuselages over to this rounded nose by hand, or if this is sort of just the way that the machining works and they can't get that part just super clean. The rest of the fuselage, however, is amazingly engineered and super clean, and this time devoid of any pointy and sharp edges. The finish on the wings is also super clean. The wings are available in sort of a race finish, a matte race finish, or like this one, and this shiny mold release finish. Same thing for the back wing, and I'm assuming the mast. If you're wondering about compatibility of the mast and fuselage to the Axis, for example, they are not compatible. The fuselage to mast mounting is different between the two systems. The Alpine Axis's master fuselage plug is a lot thinner and smaller. The Ultimate has a much sort of thicker and beefier plug connection than that. So if you're gonna get the Ultimate, you have to get the fuselage and the mast system as one. All the hardware is M6 screws with Torx heads. That's for the screws that go into the board, master fuselage connection, the four screws that hold the wings, and the two screws that hold the back wing. All right, let's talk about the performance. The race wing is a speed wing. It's relatively small and it has a very small surface area, so it needs a good amount of power and speed to start flying and get stable. In the beginning, I had some issues with dolphining, as most of the foils I'm used to riding nowadays have a much lower takeoff or stall speed. This has a relatively high stall speed, which is to be expected for this type of wing. Once you get it up to speed, it is quite stable. It is not the easiest wing to control. Saying that the pitch stability, like on all of the Alpine foils, is amazing. It really, once it gets up to speed, doesn't have any major up and downs. It doesn't tend to drop out or anything like that. However, there is one little bit of a weird thing with all the Alpine foils, is that compared to almost all the other free ride foils and race foils I'm used to, is that it doesn't have a very strong riding moment on its roll axis. Which means, normally, on other foils, when you're heeled over, once you take the pressure off the foil, those have a tendency to try to return to zero to neutral, to be straight, whereas the Alpine foils don't do it as much. This is one of the things that you have to get used to right in the beginning, especially when you're doing the maneuvers, that especially in tacks, that the foil won't by itself come up out of a heeled position. So you have to sort of change your style up a little bit to do that. And in the beginning, it feels a bit weird that you don't have this sort of automatic pull up. And then vice versa, if you're coming from an Alpine foil to another foil, it'll feel strange. So you need a little bit of time to get used to it, especially in the maneuvers. The top end speed is very good. I got over 30 with it pretty easily, pretty comfortably. I was over testing it on a quite heavy free ride board from last year. It's not exactly the best sort of speed board, so probably with a better board, a lot more practice, and let's see, better conditions, I probably could have gotten it into the mid 30s, pretty much close to 38, 40. However, with the board I had problems basically with windage. What bothered me a little bit were the massive winglets. Now, with this size of mast, which is relatively short for sort of a race or speed setup, if you get close to the surface, those winglets have a tendency to breach, or actually already to basically suck a bit of air down and force the wing up. In the beginning, I was having major problems jibing it because I was used to going, you know, quite high up on my jibes, and then immediately those wingtips would breach, suck air onto the wing, and I would crash. On tacks, if I wasn't careful, if I was heeling over too much, it was very easy to breach with these wingtips. There is a reason why most brands actually angle their wingtips down or just leave them out completely on the front wings. The yaw stability is actually also really good. Obviously, for agility and turning, it takes a while to get used to that extra length of the fuselage. Having that sort of extra yaw and pitch stability, the foil sort of tries to go for larger radius turns, and you have to vary your speed and your technique a little bit if you want tighter turns. And anyway, this race wing is not designed for really tight carving and so on. So just like any other sort of fast wing, it needs its speed to go around, so expect to have a larger radius turn. Jumping on the wing was very fun because it's a very small wing. It has a very easy release out of the water with very little hold, and landing it is also quite easy. I do have to say that the wing did develop small little micro cracks by the screw holes on the wings. So it's still a quite small wing. You should probably really know your technique before you start jumping this wing. So in conclusion, Alpine have done a really good job redesigning their foils for 2018. The Ultimate is the next step in their evolution for their foils and features some great improvements such as the sacrificial anode, the curved mast, and overall design of their fuselage. Gone is the super sharp nose that was an issue the years before, and the foil is actually really fun to ride. Just remember, the race wing is not an actual up and down regatta race wing. It is more of a long distance speed crossing wing. And if you're looking for doing long distance runs like that, it's actually one of the best foils on the markets for this. If you're however looking for up and down racing or something a little bit easier to control, then you might want to look at a wing that's slightly bigger. Thanks for watching. I hope this helped you make a decision on the Alpine Foil Ultimate 2018 with the race wing. Remember, if you like our channel, please click like and mash that bell button. And if you're interested in supporting the channel financially, please have a look at this link over here at our Patreon site. There you can actually become one of our patrons and support us financially so we can keep making these review videos and other helpful videos on this channel. Thanks for watching. See you on the water. Rock on.